This is one of the more unusual talks, and it's very rare that I find something like this. This is Exoplanet Observing for Amateurs by Bruce L. Gary. This is copyrighted 2007. And I didn't put the Carl Sagan quote in there, but I'll read this out to you guys. This is the beginning of the book. Now, mind you, this was made about 11 years ago. It was published in 2007, so probably 12, 13, however long it took to write the book. Astronomers, ironically, have traditionally tried to remain aloof from things that excited the general public. I recall JPL, which is Jet Propulsion Laboratory, cafeteria conversations in the 1970s, where I, in preface two, defended, is preface two in here, defended Carl Sagan's right to communicate his enthusiastic love for astronomy to the public. There was a pecking order in astronomy at that time, which may still exist to some extent, in which the further out your field of study is, the higher your status. Thus, cosmologists garnered the highest regard, and those who studied objects in our solar system were viewed with the least regard. My studies were of the moon, but I didn't care where I was in this hierarchy. At that time, there was only one level lower than mine, those who speculated about other worlds and the possibilities for intelligent life on them. So we'll stop there for a second. The pecking order was in the 1970s. The Big Bang people were the top, who could imagine how the entire universe came to be, which I find to be absolutely ridiculous. And the people on the lower end of the spectrum were people who are realistic and understanding, hey, you know, we might not be the only ones out there, so keep that in mind. We now know that planets are everywhere in the galaxy. Billions upon billions of planets must exist, and I estimate probably trillions of them, more or less at least 6.4 trillion water worlds in our galaxy alone. That is a lot of life. This is the message from the tally of 248 extrasolar planetary systems as of mid-2007. 248. Well, fast forward to 2019, it's 3,800 exoplanets. And this is very important also. Among them are 22 exoplanets that transit in front of their star, 15 that are brighter than 13th magnitude. And the number is growing so fast that by the time this book appears, the number could be 2 or 3 dozen. It is important to realize that bright transiting exoplanets are far more valuable than faint or non-transiting ones. I don't put value on exoplanets. I think they're all valuable because they're all evolved stars. And let this be a message to Bruce L. Gary that bright transiting exoplanets, you don't need to put the transiting in there at all. Bright exoplanets, meaning the stars themselves, are incredibly important. And I don't know, Bruce, if you pay attention to internet stuff or if you sort of shield yourself from the public like the 1970s cosmologists did, but here's a white dwarf, a nebula. This is what stars that are being born look like. They expand greatly to lose heat, and then they're really, really massive as they've been gaining mass this whole time from absorbing interstellar material. And then they start shrinking, losing mass again, and cooling, differentiating the interior and becoming the Earth-like object. This meaning the search for life out there, I think those people are number one. It's the Big Bang cosmologists and all that stuff. They're the lower rung. They're the theoretical people who just don't really have anything to add to astronomy because their heads are full of air and math equations that nobody understands. That being said, not only is it a reversal of the pecking order, so to speak, it's an absolute annihilation of the pecking order, because the people who are at the top, well, everything they've ever believed is all wrong, all of it. And the people who are considered the cranks and the crackpots, me, other people like me that I haven't even discovered yet are the people who have a lot of truth to offer. And keep that in mind. Just don't dismiss people because they have ideas that are different than yours. All right, y'all. Today is January 3rd, 2019. Take it easy.